and for the most of my 20s, I have been living a life of building cool machines and seeking outdoor adventures in the wilderness. It is my passion, and I love them both. But when my important work was over, I came home to this. It is my home in the southeast of Norway. I grew up here. A place that can be described as a little piece of heaven. Surrounded by wide open fields, brooks, waterfalls, woods, and wildflower meadows. I have so far lived a blessed and great life, being privileged to follow my dreams. Yet this is a story about a life-changing moment that made me rethink everything. To pay for my projects and lifestyle, I needed a job. So I got a job as a small engine mechanic, repairing chainsaws, lawnmowers, and garden tractors. A job I have managed to hold for close to 10 years. It has been a good job and I like it. I have worked up a good reputation for my repairing skills. So the last few years have become busy, with more customers coming in. But that means more work on me. And I am beginning to feel the pressure. But on this spring day, I would have somewhat of a wake-up call. After a busy day at work, I come home tired. Yet I need to get going to get to my other workshop to fix a car. I jump in my car and start up, but it would be a short drive. I had done the unthinkable. I had driven over my own dog. My dog, Lakota, is rushed to the nearest open veterinarian and quickly gets sedated to kill the extreme pain she's in. Her right front leg is badly injured, it's broken, and it's just dangling freely. The x-rays shows a severe broken bone, crushed by the car tire, but also several small fractures in her right paw. And to top it all off, she also suffers from internal bleedings. She needs surgery to fix the leg and needs to be sent to a specialist for some days. There's not much that I can do. Needless to say, I didn't sleep much that night. How this accident had happened was kind of a mystery. But what had happened was that my aggressive mud tires had managed to hook onto Lakota's long leash as I was backing up the car, resulting in her leash acting like a cable winch. Winched closer and closer into my tire and squashed. I'll never forget that scream. Although it was an accident, I can't help but blame myself. If I just didn't have these big, stupid tires on my car, this would never happen. The feeling of guilt is the worst. To badly injure someone you love. I try my best to get my thoughts elsewhere, and I decide to do something productive. So I try to cut some firewood. Many questions raise my mind. Will she be able to walk again? Can they save her leg? Do I need to make some kind of a wheelchair for her? Or maybe the leg has to be amputated. And it all feels like a very bad dream, a nightmare that you just can't wake up from because it's not. I just really want to put these logs down, go inside, and cry my brave tears. So I decide to do that instead. But on the positive side, she is getting the best help that she could get. And animals break bones all the time, I guess. But yet, I'm having a tough time accepting it. Time had gone fast, from the time she was a puppy to become 9 years old. And we started so early, seeking the wilderness, just me and my dog. And I had many plans. And I remember that I really wanted to take her with me to the North American wilderness. But somehow, I felt that I had spent too much time in the rat race. Too much time at my job. And not with Lakota like I planned when I got her. Although she has been on many trips with me, I felt I hadn't given her enough. The next morning, I felt a bit better. I called my boss, and I take my 4 weeks vacation early this summer, just to be home with Lakota to help her heal. But I do need to stay busy, and I have a plan. I have been playing with the idea of trying to be some kind of a farmer. That way, I can stay home and help Lakota while trying my childhood dream. Well, I don't have much land, but I can try to plant some easy stuff in my garden and see if I can grow anything. Like potatoes or carrots, perhaps. And maybe some strawberries. I do like strawberries. But I would need some tools or implements to help me cultivate the soil. A plow for around 200 euros, perhaps. A rotary cultivator, a ridger for my potatoes, a trailer would be nice, and what else? I just have to look through the classifieds, but maybe for around 750 euros I can get my farming career somewhat started. And growing up in the countryside, I do have some knowledge about farming, but I'm no expert. Obviously, to do farming, I would need a tractor, and luckily that I have already. A couple of years ago, I was online shopping on eBay, and I bought this. This is a Massey Ferguson 590 four-wheel drive, a collectible piece from 1978 that I bought from England. It weighs 4.5 tons, and it has 12 forward gears and 4 reverse gears. It does have the UK hitch on it, so I'm not even sure any of my old Norwegian implements would even fit on the back of it. But it is a nice tractor. So let's start farming. The next morning, I was eager to start my farming project. And I have to start with the equipment I already have. a rotary tiller from the 1950s. So I get it connected on the back of my way too big of a tractor and head towards my lawn. Take the tiller and dig up almost 1,000 square feet of what used to be the lawn. Who really needs a lawn anyway? The soil is very good. And luckily, my farming neighbor had this old pile of manure that I could use as fertilizer for my own little garden. As they say, no shit, no roses. I was starting to enjoy my small farming project already. It felt nice and productive to plant potatoes and carrots in the ground, like a fresh start, which was exactly what I needed. And it brought my thoughts away from Lakota and the accident. But not for long, because my phone was ringing. The surgery was successful, and I can come and pick up Lakota. I got Lakota home safely, and the bone specialist man, named John, did a fantastic job. But it would cost me 7,500 euros to fix her, and I need to sell a lot of potatoes to cover that bill. Despite the metal rods sticking out of her leg and doped on painkillers, she is in pretty good shape. She mostly sleeps under a table, and she got this cone of shame around her neck. She really wants to join me outdoors, but the vets have given me strict message for her to not move about. Other than giving her painkillers and rest, I can only use the time as the greatest healer. But it does seem that my touch seems to calm her down a little. But she is an Alaskan Malamute, a very tough and hardy breed, built for pulling heavy sleds in the Arctic. So, she will get through this current pain she's in, I just know that. Thank you. yet. I feel I want to do more for her. So when she finally calms down, I have a very special mission in mind. I want to make a special bomb out of natural herbs that I can find in my local forest. Kinda like what the Native Americans did. So I jump on a very special tractor to take me to the woods. My father's restored Ferguson 35, which has been in my family for many years. While being attacked by mosquitoes, I try to scout around for the herbs then that I'm after. Meadowsweet, known for its healing properties. Fireweed as an antibacterial. Mixed with some pine sap and beeswax. This can be made into a great wound healing balm. And some self-promoting, it's important these days. Magnus Guard. June, and my potatoes have grown quite high already. So while Lakota is resting, I spend my days weeding my vegetables and doing small tasks around the farm. It is good old-fashioned work, but the truth is that I love it. Working with nature. Nature has so far been a good boss for me. But I am a little worried about Limpy over here. We have a long way to go to full recovery. And it does worry me if she ever can use her leg again, like she used to do. But she seems happy, despite her injury. and she really wants to follow me around on the farm. There is a lot of babysitting, but it could be worse. You just have to be patient with her. But my farming career has now reached a small milestone, because the time has come to start harvest my first homegrown vegetable. The marrow, zucchini, squash thing is ready. I am super pleased with my squash. Good size, and they taste good. And the best thing is that I have managed to get some customers lined up for them, so I can start to sell them. When I say sell, I mean give away, because nobody wants to pay for homegrown vegetables anymore. So zero income on the squash. As evening time comes around, Lakota gets her pills, and I get some reading time. Reading tractor magazines. A hobby I had as a kid, but now kinda blossomed again. And I keep an eye on the equipment classifieds for any old and beaten up farm machinery that I could buy cheap. Well, being an unsuccessful squash farmer is tiresome, but the good kind. So, I take an early night, but I am looking forward to a summer of farming, hoping at least the potatoes can bring some income.